We started with the Mr. Clean brand, and we created the Mr. Clean car wash. Physical locations where people go and get their car cleaned. And now, in order for us to do this, it meant a few changes had to take place. First off, we had to go from being a products company to a services company. We also had to move from being largely a B2B company that sold its products through retailers like Walmart to now selling directly to consumers. And lastly, we had to become very much an entrepreneurial startup with just a few million in revenue. As you can imagine, this was fairly uncomfortable for a 175-year-old, $80 billion products company. But it started to work. And I remember exactly when it hit me that this was working. I was doing a site visit. This was just after maybe we launched our first dozen or so locations. And I was just talking it up with different customers as they were coming in through the car wash lobby. And I struck up a conversation with one guy, and he mentioned that he comes every single Sunday from a part of town that's 15 miles away and past 8 competitive car washes. I looked it up afterwards. This is fantastic. We've never seen loyalty like this anywhere on our business. What's going on? Must be our fantastic products, right? No, he didn't even care about cleaning his car. The real reason why he came every single Sunday is because we had installed these water guns for the kids to help clean the cars as they drove by the tunnel, and his son absolutely loved it. So he saw coming to Mr. Clean to get his car washed as an opportunity for creating a memorable experience for his son to look back on when he's old. Priceless. And from a business standpoint, we essentially created this brand memory that was neurologically imprinted onto their brain, creating multi-generational loyalty that is virtually competition-proof. All because we took Mr. Clean out of the bottle and structured our overall business model around generating life profit.